Welcome to the Michigan Golfer Show. Join us each week as we explore the people, the places, and the events that shape our great game.
Hi, I'm Susan Bairley, and I'm reporting to you from the K Club in Kildare County, Ireland.
Say when. What's your call?
Gemani Dilly between the Oshle is Misha Sharony Dillon, Agus is more and honor them. Sharman is Oscarse, Huron Ryder, Robbie Legas O'Shea, a car of our Lahart Tranula. Ladies and gentlemen, Ireland stands proud this afternoon. After years of painstaking preparation, we are ready to bring to you the 2006 Ryder Cup. And so, ladies and gentlemen, it is a heartfelt Cade Mila Foilte or 100,000 welcomes that we extend to you across the world from the spectacular K Club in County Kildare. My name is Sharon Nivolan, and I'm honoured to act as your MC for today's opening ceremony. The Ryder Cup theme, which you've just heard, was composed especially for this event by Donal Lunny, one of Ireland's most renowned musicians. Over the next 3 days, the greatest golfers of Europe and the United States will compete for this famous gold trophy. The celebrated cup bearing the name of Samuel Ryder and the figurine of his golf mentor, Abe Mitchell. We are thrilled that this great golfing contest, established in 1927 and now one of the biggest events in world sport, has come to Ireland. And as the introduction you've just seen suggests, well, the gods, they seem happy too. And it's little wonder the gods are happy. Golf was first played here 400 years ago. Our island now boasts 415 registered golf courses, the oldest of which at the Curragh, just 20 miles from here, opened in 1852. So we have tradition. We also have Mother Nature on our side, helping to make our magnificent old links courses among the most beautiful places to play golf anywhere in the world. In the last 15 years, we've complemented these by creating spectacular new facilities. One such, the K Club, is proud to host this Ryder Cup on behalf of all Irish golf. And so, ladies and gentlemen, this is the backdrop, this is the setting for the 36th Ryder Cup match, an event of great importance to all the people of Ireland. And to give expression to the pride we all feel, it's my honour now to introduce our president, An Tuathrán Mary McAleese. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the presidential salute. And welcome to the Ryder Cup. It's with great pride that I offer each of you the traditional Irish Cead Mila Foilte of 100,000 welcomes as we gather here in the beautiful K Club for the 2006 Ryder Cup. All around the world, millions of golf enthusiasts are joining us by internet, by radio, by television for this celebrated team golf competition, which pits the greatest golfers from the United States against the best from Europe.
I particularly welcome the members of both teams, their families, their friends, their supporters, and of course the media who are here in force to capture the drama of this mighty contest. The Ryder Cup has come, as you've heard, to the home of the oldest golfing union in the world and to a country with a legendary golfing tradition. With those over 400 courses that Sharon mentioned, we are said to have more golf courses per head of population than anywhere else in the world. And of course, we are also the proud possessors of 40% of the world's links courses. So we take our golf seriously, but we have fun taking it seriously. No surprise then, of course, to see Ireland so well represented on the European team. And we wish Darren, Padraig and Paul the very, very best of Irish luck. Our ambitions for the 2006 Ryder Cup, you know, they're very simple. We want it to be a thrilling showcase of golf and of Ireland. We want the colossal effort which has gone into organising this terrific event to be rewarded by a great tournament. Most of all, we want this Ryder Cup to be the most enjoyable, the most memorable ever. A big congratulations to everyone who has worked so hard to bring the 2006 Ryder Cup to our beautiful country and to this beautiful county of Kildare. Every success to the golfing geniuses who are going to keep Ireland and the world enthralled over the next 3 days. Gura míle míle maithagas, thank you very much and enjoy the golf.
With the support of our Ryder Cup band and orchestra. Welcome Cara Dillon and Irla O'Lennard. We have Bernard Gallagher, Ray Floyd, Mark James, Sam Torrance, John Jacobs, Brian Huggett, Tony Jacklin, Bernard Hunt, and the wonderful course on which this Ryder Cup match will be played, US captain on two occasions in 1963 and 1975. Ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest players in the history of the game, Mr. Arnold Palmer. For former captains of Ryder Cup. Now, our next musical interlude features another legendary figure in Celtic music, but this man hails from Galicia. The northern region of Spain has been referred to as the world's undiscovered Celtic nation, and its greatest musical talent as the Jimi Hendrix of Celtic music. Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome, please, a man who plays Celtic music with Spanish passion, Mr. Carlos Núñez.
Honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure to stand before you today as President of PGA of America here at the 36th Ryder Cup. I look at this throng of people and I realize that we are among friends and kindred spirits. And what brings us together is a love of the game of golf and a love of the Ryder Cup. And it's great to be with you today. PGA of America is an association of 28,000 men and women golf professionals in the United States who are committed to making sure that the game of golf continues to prosper and grow and everyone who plays the game has fun. We have been a proud caretaker with the PGA of Great Britain and Ireland and the European Ryder Cup Committee in making sure that the Ryder Cup continues to advance its legacy and continue to be the greatest golf event in the world. I'm proud to say that this year, 2006, is the 90th anniversary of the PGA of America. In 1916, 35 golf professionals got together in New York City and formed the PGA of America. The mission of the PGA of America, back established in 1916, was twofold: to raise the professional standards of the profession and to grow participation in the game of golf.
Eamon Darcy. Christy O'Connor Jr. John O'Leary. Eddie Poland. Hugh Boyle. Norman Drew. And as we we did with Arnold Palmer, a special reference for himself, Christy O'Connor Sr. An equal number representing the United States of America will play, as they've done since 1927, to attain the coveted Ryder Cup. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please give a huge Irish welcome to both teams as they join us on stage, led by their captains Ian Woosnam and Tom Lehman, and followed by their two vice-captains. Ladies and gentlemen, the teams to compete in the 36th Ryder Cup match. Ryder Cup, but to be chosen as Ryder Cup captain is considered the ultimate accolade. That honour was bestowed on Tom Lehman in November of 2004. He is a major winner, the Open champion in 1996 at Royal Lytham and St Anne's. He competed in three successive Ryder Cups as a player, 1995, 1997 and 1999. He's a former world number one, no stranger to Ireland and the rain. He's the captain of the 36th team to represent the United States in the Ryder Cup. Please welcome to the podium Mr. Tom Lehman.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Honored guests, ladies and gentlemen. Both teams, I'm not sure about you, but seeing those flags go up is quite a moment. And I am very, very honored and proud to be here. Thank you. You know, there is such a strong bond, a strong connection between the United States and between Ireland. So much of our country's history has been shaped by men and women with origins in this country. And I think it's only fitting that we celebrate this Ryder Cup right here this year, and I am so honored to be here. So thank you to all you Irish fans, European fans. I want you to have a great time, enjoy yourself, and have a lot of fun. To the American fans here, to our family, to our friends, we want to give you something to cheer about. You guys have a great time too. To Ian Woosnam, to Uzi and your team, I know the honor and the pride that you feel about being the captain. You've done a great job. I'm sure your family is very proud of you. You gotta be very proud of yourself. I'm sure your team is very proud of you. And to the European team, the best of luck. We have great respect for all of you. Best luck to everybody. You know, also watching the flag goes up, it reminds me of some very special friends we visited last week at Walter Reed Hospital in Washington. And I promised them that when I got the chance that I would tell you guys that we support you and we love you. And now, it gives me great honor to introduce to you the Ryder Cup team from the United States of America. Assistant Captain Lauren Roberts, Assistant Captain Corey Pavin, Scott Verplank, Stuart Sink, Brett Wetterick, Zach Johnson, JJ Henry, Vaughn Taylor, Chris DeMarco, David Toms, Chad Campbell, Jim Furyk, Phil Mickelson, and Tiger Woods. This is our team, and we promise to give you an event that you always remember, filled with sportsmanship, with compassion, with fierce competition, but with more than anything, mutual respect. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you, Tom, for introducing your group.
As they say here in Ireland, Camila Fortia, a thousand welcomes to you all. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Tom and Melissa, players and partners of the United States Ryder Cup team, officials of the PGA of America, and of course, you the fans. Those with you here now, and the thousands that will join us over the next 3 days of competition, not to forget the millions watching on television. They say it could be over $1 billion. To each and every one of you, welcome to Ireland, welcome to the 2006 Ryder Cup, and welcome to you, the best golf fans in the world. You have waited a very long time for the Ryder Cup to come to Ireland, and as we all know, Ireland is famous for its hospitality and famous for its crack and for giving us so many great names have played in the Ryder Cup, who we heard their names earlier on. On behalf of the European team, my players and the ladies, my support team, Des Smith, Peter Baker, Sandy Lyle and David Russell, and all the officials of the European Ryder Cup team, and of course my wife, Glenn. I would first and foremost like to thank Dr. Michael Smurfit and all officials, staff and members of the K Club for their fantastic work in preparing the outstanding Parma course for this, the 2006 Ryder Cup. Thank you. I want now to take a moment to pay tribute to a man who's been an inspiration to us all. He has won 4 Masters titles, 2 Open Championships, and a US Open, and a designer of the golf course we are playing this week, the legend himself, Mr. Arnold Palmer. Very special Welshman, Di Rees, and European Ryder Cup team, and of course my wife, Glenn. I would first and foremost like to thank Dr. Michael Smurfit and all officials, staff and members of the K Club for their fantastic work in preparing the outstanding Parma course for this, the 2006 Ryder Cup. Thank you. I want now to take a moment to pay tribute to a man who's been an inspiration to us all. He has won 4 Masters titles, 2 Open Championships, and a US Open, and a designer of the golf course we are playing this week, the legend himself, Mr. Arnold Palmer. Very special Welshman, Di Rees and Brian Huggett. And for me now, it is a great honour to follow them by coming the third Welshman to captain a Ryder Cup team. This week's venue, the K Club, is an absolutely spectacular setting for such a historic match as the Ryder Cup. And I would especially like to thank the many volunteers without whom it would not be possible for this match to take place and continue the wonderful traditions which has passed from one generation to another since Samuel Ryder presented this magnificent trophy for competition. In 1927, Walter Hagen and Ted Ray stood as Ryder Cup captains for the very first time. And now 79 years later, Tom and I are very proud and honored to follow them and write another chapter in the history of this great event. I would like to congratulate all the players who have played some wonderful golf to make it here this week. They are the best 24 golfers from both sides of the pond. They are fantastic competitors and have the greatest respect for each other. So gentlemen, we wish you all the best of luck over the next 3 days of competition. Good luck, guys. Nearly 2 years ago, the PGA of America made a smart decision. They appointed Tom Lehman as captain of the 2006 United States team. Tom is a very wise man, and I know he'll get the very best out of his team this week. Congratulations, Tom, and good luck to you and the United States team. This week is all about honour and tradition, sportsmanship and integrity. And like all the captains and teams before us, we stand here knowing that we are playing with pride and passion for the honour for holding the cup. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is what the Ryder Cup is all about. Tom, you and I and our tag team members share total respect for the virtues of the true competitive sportsmanship on which the Ryder Cup has flourished for almost 80 years. Now we invite every spectator, every fan, to uphold the traditions of the game as the eyes of the world focus on our sport. Win or lose, we the players, our wives and partners, the officials and you the fans will join hands to ensure that together we will write another chapter in the history of this incredible game that we all love so much. As the European team captain, I now have the honour and the privilege to introduce our 2006 teams. My vice captains, Des Smith, Peter Baker, Paul Casey, Aaron Clark, Luke Gold, Sergio Garcia, Audrey Harrington, and David Howell, Robert Carlson, Paul McGinley, Colin Montgomery, Jose Maria Lazadel, Henrik Stenson, and Lee Wessler. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you, and may the best team win.